In this video, we will demonstrate experiment 3, the determination of the formula of a compound using the copper and sulfur reaction. Weigh a crucible and lid, and then obtain a piece of copper and coil it around a pencil to get it into the shape shown here. You will then reweigh it, and then begin adding sulfur directly to the copper wire. You will want to add enough sulfur so that you completely coat the copper wire, as shown here. You will not need to weigh out the amount of sulfur because we are adding an excess to this reaction to make it go to completion. Once you've added enough sulfur, take the crucible over to a Bunsen burner where you have already lit a bright blue flame. You may need to lower your crucible down into the flame to get your reaction started. If the crucible is at the right level in the flame, you will see that the sulfur begins to melt and changes from bright yellow in color to red-brown. You will also notice some vigorous bubbling and perhaps a little bit of smoke coming off of the crucible. This is normal. After a few more seconds, the sulfur is almost completely melted. Once this occurs, you will want to get your crucible lid ready and cover the reaction completely. Then remove the Bunsen burner flame. You will want to allow this to react for 5 minutes undisturbed. After waiting 5 minutes, there are two methods for removing the excess sulfur. The first is to place the crucible without the lid directly into a bright blue flame and allow the excess sulfur to boil off. You will see this in the form of brown droplets and brown gas coming off of the sulfur. You will continue to heat it until you see that almost all of the sulfury tar is gone, and the only thing remaining is a coil, which has changed from orange to a grayish color. The other option is to just place your crucible in a triangle directly into the flame. You will want your crucible pretty close to your flame so that you generate enough heat to remove the excess sulfur. Again, you want to make sure your lid is off while you do this so that you do not cause any explosions. As with the previous method, this reaction is very vigorous and will still form the brown gas and droplets that we saw previously. You will still continue to heat until you have removed all of the excess sulfur and no longer see any of the brown gas coming off of the reaction. Again, you will want to make sure that there is no longer any brown gas coming off when you finish heating, and it should look like a tarnished gray coil when you are finished. The last step is to remove any sulfur that may have gotten on your crucible lid. You can hold the lid with your tongs and move it gently back and forth in a bright blue flame. Once you have removed the excess sulfur from your crucible lid, you can put it back on the crucible and weigh the entire system to obtain a mass.